Good. In this video, we'll be looking at Venn diagrams. In the previous videos, we looked at ways of expressing a set. And so far, we have looked at three ways. The first one was listing elements of a set. You can see an example here. If you have, for instance, set A, and then we have elements 1, 2, and 3. We are just listing the elements. And then the second way was describing elements. For instance, if we have set A, and then we say the set of integers, that's a description, just like the way it says describing. And then the third way was using set builder notation. A perfect example, if we have set B, and then it says set B contains all the elements of X, such that X is less than or equal to 10, and X is greater than or equal to 5. That is set builder notation. Or you can have a set A such that all the elements of X, such that X is an even number and X is between 4 and 20. That's still set builder notation. Now when we introduce now another way of expressing a set, which we can now use a rectangle. Since we're now looking at Venn diagrams, we use a rectangle, and that rectangle we indicate it by that symbol epsilon to represent the universal set. And then under the rectangle or inside the rectangle, we now draw in circles. The circles, they represent subsets of the universal set. In this case, we have set A and set B. Set B is the set of natural numbers, and set A is the set of integers. Now, by definition, integers, these are positive and negative numbers. We can say, for instance, negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, up to positive infinity. And natural numbers, by definition, these are counting numbers starting from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, up to positive infinity. You can already see that all these numbers, the natural numbers, they also fall under the set of integers. That's why you see that set B is a proper subset of set A, and set A is a subset of the universal set. That is what Venn diagrams are. Let's look at an example. Let's quickly look at an example here. Suppose we have let me just write example here. Suppose we have a universal set represented by the Greek letter epsilon containing the elements 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9, 11, 16. That is our universal set. And then suppose now we have set A with elements. Remember, we are using curly brackets, not round brackets or square brackets. We're using curly brackets. Suppose set A has elements 2, 3, 5, 7, and 11. And then suppose set B has elements 1, 4, 9, and 16. And then set C. Set C, we have 3, 6, and then 9. Suppose we have 3 sets. And now, the question says, letter A. Draw a Venn diagram to show this information. And then letter B. Suppose now here, question says, write down the value of the number of elements of C complement intersection set C. Suppose we have a question like that. Let's quickly look at the solution. Letter A. Let me use a different color. Now for letter A is very easy. So what we need, we only need to represent the universal set with the Greek letter epsilon. And then we have now to draw a rectangle like that. We draw our rectangle. Remember, the rectangle represents the universal set. Let's draw our rectangle then. Okay, we have our rectangle. And then the second thing to do, since we have 3 sets, set A, set B, and set C, since we have 3 sets, these are the subsets of the universal set. If you can check very well, you'll see that all the elements of set C and the elements of set B and the elements of set A, they are all contained in the universal set. Now, since they are subsets of the universal set, what we need to do, we now represent the 3 sets or the subsets with circles inside the rectangle. This will be our first circle, and this is our second circle, and then we have our third circle. Good. Now what we need to do, we need to label this subset. Let me use a different color. Suppose the first one is set A, and then the last one is set B, and then the middle one is set C. The reason why set C is in the middle is because if you look at the element of set C, which is 3, you will see that set A is also 3. That means 3 is the intersection of set A and set C. That's why C is in the middle. And also if you look at the element of set C, which is 9, you also see that 9 is an element of set B. Therefore, 9 is the intersection of set C and B. That's why C is in the middle. Now let's begin now to fill the elements in the diagram. Now we can start with set A. We have 2 there, and then we have 3, but in this case 3, our 3 here is actually an intersection of 2 sets, which is set A and set C. Therefore we write it here. And then we have 5, and then we have 7 there, and then we have 11. Set A, we are done. Let's look at set C. Set C, we only have 3 elements. The first one is an intersection between set A and set C, and then the last one, which is 9, is an intersection between set B and set C. Therefore we write 9 there. And then the only element that we are left with is 6. Therefore we write 6 there. And then we look at set B. Set B, we have 9, which is an element, which is an intersection of set C and B, and the rest they are not contained in other sets. Therefore, we write 1, 4, and then 16. And then we are done for letter A. For letter A, we are done. Let us now move on to letter B. Letter B. Now with letter B, in order for us to find the cardinality of C complement intersection set A, first we have to find the value of, not the value, but the elements of C complement or C prime. So C complement will be the elements of the universal set which do not appear in set C. Elements of the universal set, but they are not elements of the set C. And if we can look at that, let me use a different ink to show that. Here we have 3, 6, and 9. We have 3, 6, and 9. So our C complement, by definition, when we are looking at complement, we are looking at the elements in the universal set, but these elements do not belong to our set C. In this case, 3, 6, and 9, they're also here. Now, except these three elements, the rest of them, we can now write them here. Therefore, we'll have 1, 2, and then 3, we skip it because we have 3 here, and then we move on to 4, and then we have 5, and then we have 7, we skip 6, and then we have 11, we skip 9, and then the last one is 16, and that's our C complement. Now, once we have found our C complement, let me quickly write down our set A here as it is. As it is there, let me quickly write it down here. We have set A having elements 2, 3, 5, 7, and then 11. Now, for us now to find the second thing that we need to do here, in order for us to find the cardinality of C complement intersection set A, we have to find this set. We have to find that set, C complement intersection A, before we look at the cardinality. Now, in this case, we are looking at the elements that are appearing here. Intersection, we are looking at the elements that are appearing in both of the sets. In this case, we have 2 here. In C complement, we have 2 there, which we also have here. 2 there and 2 here. And we also have 5 there. And we also have 5 here, and we have 7 there, and we also have 7 here, and the last one is 11, and we also have 11 here. These are the elements that are appearing in both of the sets. Now we can write them. We can write them. Let me use curly brackets. We have 2, 5, 7, 11. Now, once we are done doing that, what we can now do, we can now try to find the cardinality. The cardinality of C complement intersection A. So what we have to do here, we just count, we look at this set and then we just count the individual numbers. In this case, we have 1, 2, 3, 4. There are only 4 elements. So the answer is 4. Good. I hope you understand how we arrived at the answer 4. Now, in order to test yourself, let me give you this activity to do. That's your activity to do. And then in the next video, I'll show you how to solve this activity. Thank you.